As humans, we're all good at different things. I myself am an excellent cross-stitcher and a black belt in karate. The same is true for wrestlers. Some, like Bret Hart or Kurt Angle, are historically tremendous when it comes to gritty singles action. Others are completely at home with a weapon in hand or a ladder to jump off. Just take a look at Mick Foley or Jeff Hardy. Bloody hell, Jeff, how did you get up there? In WWE, some superstars seem to shift things into a higher gear when faced with a certain match type. Steve Austin has elevated many a Royal Rumble with his sheer intensity and charisma. There are Hell in a Cell matches, and then there are Undertaker Hell in a Cell matches. And of course, Randy Orton just loves a traditional Survivor Series bout, something that has never really been acknowledged or explained. Today, however, we are focusing on the Elimination Chamber. Elimination Chamber matches have been around for over 15 years now, more than enough time for several superstars to make their mark. Who immediately springs to mind when the stipulation is mentioned, and which wrestlers deserve to be known as pioneers of the chamber match? Let's find out. I'm Adam Pacitti from Cultaholic.com, and these are the 10 best Elimination Chamber performers of all time. Join us. Number 10, John Morrison. John Morrison's in-ring style is partly based around parkour. If you're unfamiliar with parkour, it's that thing that all the skater kids in your school got really into for just one summer. You know, when they used to get all happy on branded energy drinks and jump over a low park bench. Unlike parkour enthusiasts, Morrison is very much one of the cool kids. Also, unlike parkour enthusiasts, Morrison is actually good at parkour. His offense is specifically based around using the environment and his own athleticism to gain an advantage, i.e. he should be a boss when it comes to Elimination Chamber matches. It might therefore come as a surprise to hear that Mr. Impact has only ever been in two Elimination Chamber bouts. Mr. Impact. Wow. He first appeared in the 2010 SmackDown Chamber and had the audacity to last until the final three alongside Chris Jericho and The Undertaker. The following year, he took part in the Raw Chamber match and gave us one of the most memorable eliminations of all time. After scaling the side of the chamber using his sweet parkour skills, Morrison hurled himself downwards like a handsome thunderbolt, nailing Sheamus and instantly ending his night. Also, when climbing around on the walls, he moved a little bit like the giant spider from inside the Deku Tree. I have no idea if that's true, but Jack really wanted me to include the reference. Number 9, Batista. Sometimes people hate things, and that's just part of life. Raven hates Tommy Dreamer, The Miz hates Daniel Bryan, and Brock Lesnar hates you. I mean, Lesnar hates everything, but he especially hates you. He hates the way you're watching right now, specifically you. One of the less noticed blood feuds in WWE is Batista's clear disdain for the Elimination Chamber stipulation. He is the Antichrist, the dark matter of the Elimination Chamber, right from the moment he first stepped into such a match in 2005. Despite having been eliminated, he still stuck around to help Evolution stablemate Triple H crush Randy Orton. Just no respect for the rules, Dave. Continuing this theme, his most memorable chamber moment didn't even come in the match itself, winning the title from an exhausted John Cena after the bout in 2010. Vince gave him an immediate title shot because he's Vince McMahon, dammit. Do you need a reason? Thankfully, in 2008, Batista managed to obey the rules for once, battling through to the final two for a showdown with The Undertaker. He lost, but he remains one of the best Nasty Boys in chamber history. I'm not saying he's one of the actual Nasty Boys, that'd be weird. Number 8, Shawn Michaels. Conventional wisdom dictates that most match types are improved by having Shawn Michaels in there, so it should be no surprise to find him on this list. HBK has competed in 3 Elimination Chamber matches, but also managed to involve himself in a couple of others. HBK has the distinction of winning the first ever chamber match at Survivor Series 2000, last defeating Triple H in a battle of the backstage politicians. Michaels was a few months into his unlikely comeback, so we'd all had time to forget what a cheeky chap he was in the 90s. He also fought in 2 other bouts, but neither were quite as memorable. In 2003, he was turned into roadkill by Goldberg, and in 2008, he gave Triple H his win back because they're best friends. However, Michaels also involved himself in 2 other Elimination Chamber matches. He refereed the 2005 edition and took part in the elimination of Edge, revenge for Edge accidentally spearing HBK and not really seeming very sorry about it. In 2010, he waited under the chamber floor, all night presumably, before bursting up from below like a cowboy mole to cost The Undertaker the match. Number 7, The Undertaker. Speaking of the dead man, he seems absolutely perfect for the Elimination Chamber stipulation. Throughout his career, Undertaker's 2 favorite hobbies have been scaring the life out of his opponents and being very tough to beat in wrestling matches. It's a combination that works well given the rules of the chamber, allowing Taker to either battle through multiple opponents for a long amount of time or watch menacingly from inside one of the pods. Maybe sometimes doing that eye thing he can do. But despite being tailor-made for the Elimination Chamber, Undertaker has only taken part in 3 matches. We've already mentioned how he triumphed over Batista in 2008 and was screwed by Shawn Michaels in 2010, both key moments in chamber history. That leaves his other appearance in 2009, which was an interesting one, shall we say. WWE Champion Edge was shockingly eliminated first, meaning that we could be guaranteed a new champ by the end of the match. You're not going to believe this, but it wasn't Vladimir Kozlov. It was actually Triple H, who last eliminated Undertaker despite the Dead Man entering last, and therefore being the fresher man. The game being kayfabe tougher than Undertaker just feels wrong, but he did at least return the favour at two consecutive WrestleManias, where, as we all know, Undertaker has special granddaddy power-ups. Number 6, Randy Orton. Randy Orton may be one of the most popular superstars in the history of the business, but that doesn't stop the internet from calling him boring a lot of the time. He never changes, he never does anything different, we say, but I do think that the Elimination Chamber proves otherwise. Orton may well be the most versatile competitor in Chamber history, fulfilling a variety of roles over the course of six different matches. He was a brave babyface in 2005, screwed at the very end by former Evolution buddies Batista and Triple H. He was a despicable corporate heel in 2014, relying on the help of Kane to defeat the insanely popular Daniel Bryan, and he was one of Goldberg's tackling dummies in 2003, which sort of speaks for itself. The Viper might not be a wrestler particularly associated with the Elimination Chamber, but I feel he certainly deserves his place in the match's history. Sure, he may have gained a reputation for doing and saying things the same way for the vast majority of his career, but you could say that in the physical confines of the Elimination Chamber, Orton is actually at his most free. That's quite possibly the most pretentious thing I've ever said in my entire life, and I am truly sorry. Let's move on. Number 5, John Cena. The Elimination Chamber is a big match, isn't it? There's always a title or title shot on the line, which is a pretty big deal for starters. The chamber itself is big, with all that steel and glass and bits of floor. If only there was a man known for taking part in big matches. That'd be brilliant. He'd win every time. Actually, Large Match Jonathan has taken part in 6 Elimination Chambers, and only won 3 of them. Try harder, John. Pull your socks up. Never give up, and so on. I'm kidding, of course. A 50% chamber record is very dominant indeed, which may seem like a bad thing given all the Super Cena criticism we've seen over the years. It's important to realize, however, that even when John Cena wins an Elimination Chamber match, he still usually loses. In 2006, a bloody Cena had managed to retain his title against all odds, only for Edge to cash in the first ever Money in the Bank contract and change the wrestling world forever. Then, after again winning in 2010, Batista cashed in his Vince McMahon likes me more than you contract with the same result. Not to sound like a Cena hater, but matches where he gets eliminated midway through are even more fun. That's because we've been so conditioned to watching him dominate over the years, it always feels more important when he's taken out of contention. Well done, John. Despite winning the damn thing 3 times, you are our favorite Elimination Chamber loser. Number 4, Rey Mysterio. Rey Mysterio has one of the least impressive chamber records on this list, with 3 appearances and 0 wins. That's the same as Wade Barrett, and while I really like Barrett and consider myself his best friend in the whole world, he's not really somebody I would associate with Elimination Chamber brilliance. So why does Rey Mysterio deserve such a high ranking? Because for some reason, when those steel walls and glass pods come down, Rey starts wrestling like it's 1997 again. He made the final 2 in both 2009 and 2011, losing to Edge on both occasions. Although never quite managing to get past the Rated R superstar, both of Rey's performances were some of the very best in Elimination Chamber history. He also took one of my favorite bumps in the history of the stipulation. Towards the end of the 2009 bout, Rey charged directly at Edge, only to be scooped up and splattered headfirst into the side of a pod like a tattooed pancake. Wonderful. Number 3, Triple H. Unless you're playing Mike Tyson's Punch-Out, you're probably not going to face too many final bosses in a bog-standard ring. Usually, video games give us some evil razzmatazz to create a foreboding atmosphere, and that's always nice to see. What I'm trying to say with the use of that rather clumsy metaphor is that Triple H is the final boss of WWE, and that the Elimination Chamber is his battle arena. The game has made the stipulation his own, competing in 6 matches and winning 4. Yes, the game has won around 66% of the time, making him statistically the winningest man in chamber history. If your life was dependent on the result of an Elimination Chamber match, it would probably be wiser to back Triple H instead of the 5 other wrestlers combined. But which is the most impressive of his chamber victories? In 2005, he needed Batista's help, so it can't be that one. In 2008, he last pinned Jeff Hardy, which is impressive in that Jeff is a resilient and tricky customer, but is also the wrestling equivalent of a massive dad battering his teenage daughter's boyfriend. 2009 saw Triple H last eliminate Undertaker, which is obviously huge, but I'm going to opt for 2003. The 2003 Elimination Chamber was specifically designed to make Goldberg look like the most terrifying man in the history of the world, and Triple H still had the audacity to win the damn thing. You have to respect that. Sort of. Number 2, Edge. Naughty, naughty Edge. Wrestling in four Elimination Chamber matches is a decent amount, certainly more than most. But Edge seems to have created enough memorable moments in this match type, it feels as though he's been in about 10 of them. The Rated R Superstar first appeared in the 2005 Chamber, which was almost unfairly stacked. Despite sharing the ring with Triple H, Orton, Batista, Benoit, and Jericho, he still managed to stand out, accidentally wiping out special guest referee Shawn Michaels with an errant spear. As we discovered earlier, that did sort of lead to Edge's elimination, which is a shame for him. In 2009, however, Edge created two of the most memorable moments in Chamber history, managing to look like a massive fool and an evil genius in the same night. He first defended his WWE Championship in the SmackDown Chamber and was eliminated in 3 minutes. Everybody laughed and there was much rejoicing. Then, later on, he hijacked the Raw Chamber, ambushing Kofi Kingston, locking himself inside a pod, and taking his place before the match had officially started. After such antics, there could only really be one winner of the match, but Edge almost had us convinced otherwise, thanks to his phenomenal final showdown with Rey Mysterio. Even when he wasn't in a chamber match, Edge found a way to leave his mark, particularly with that cash-in at New Year's Revolution 2006. And yet, there's still one superstar who has owned the Elimination Chamber like nobody else. Number 1, Chris Jericho. Without question, Y2J is the man when it comes to Elimination Chamber matches, and he's only won one of them. First of all, Jericho has competed in more of these bouts than anybody else, with a current total of 8. Now, admittedly, simply being present doesn't guarantee quality, which is actually the first tip in my big book of sex advice coming soon to a store near you. Jericho, however, has certainly made the most of his many chamber appearances. His notable moments include being a human ragdoll for the first two bouts, being smashed through a pod on consecutive occasions. In 2009, he masterminded one of the most shocking eliminations ever, where he, Mysterio, and Edge hit consecutive finishes on John Cena to take him out of the match early. That is perhaps one of the best moments ever seen in the Elimination Chamber, not because Cena got eliminated and it's fun to boo him, but because it reinforced the stipulation. The Elimination Chamber should be about strategy and uneasy alliances at least a little more often. This sort of sums up why Jericho is the ultimate chamber performer. No matter what he finds himself doing, he always seems to be reacting appropriately to the ever-changing situation around him. It's ironic then that his only chamber win left him looking utterly dumbstruck. In 2010, with a seemingly indestructible Undertaker looming over him, Y2J was handed the win on a silver platter thanks to the interfering Shawn Michaels. It's certainly Jericho's biggest Elimination Chamber moment, but he's helped to create so many more for his opponents over the years. And that's our list. Let us know what you think in the comments below, and you can follow me on Twitter here. If you enjoy what we do here at Cultaholic, you can pledge to our Patreon, that's patreon.com/cultaholic. And most importantly, don't forget to smash that subscribe button, bro, and join us.